Hi everybody, I'm Todd with Sound Pure. We're here in the Sound Pure facility and we're lucky enough to have with us Anthony DiMaria. Since we use the ADL600 in our studio almost every day, we thought it'd be nice to have him say a few words about it. And fortunately, he's kind enough to do that for us.
Absolutely.
So I guess the first question I have is, how did you come up with, the basis for the design of the preamp?
Well, we looked at about 20 different designs, really old designs, things that were used maybe with the Beatles. What we noticed was that on those designs, we could make them so that they were really versatile in what most studio owners and artists would be using today.
What did you find out about those old units that you liked or didn't like?
Most of them, we noticed, were underpowered. And what happens is when you underpower, a preamp, you get a lot of sag and you don't get the really good transients. So we wanted to make sure on this design that the power supply was overly designed. And with that, you get really, really good separation between the channels. You get really good transients. And it allows for a great versatility in the unit. You can use it for just about anything from vocals to guitar to piano. What we noticed was most preamps, at low volume, it's no problem. Most preamps are okay. It's when you start to demand a lot of gain out of a pre, that's what kind of separates many preamps.
What all goes into making this thing as heavy as it is?
The classic design is transformer in and out. So there's four transformers in there right now in the audio section. There's a lot of iron in those transformers. Also, the power supply transformer is really heavy. So we wanted to have a really rugged box. We wanted to make sure it was roadworthy, whether it be in the studio, whether it be on tour somewhere. And that's what really adds weight to this particular design.
You were mentioning to me earlier today about the transformer design, in particular them being low wound transformers, and could you maybe tell us a little bit about what that means?
Sure. When you have transformers that have a high wind rate, for instance, similar to a V72, you'll notice that it's a very dark sounding unit, which limits its ability to be used on a variety of projects. So we wanted to make sure that that this design was capable of handling just about any project that was happening. So that meant low wind transformers.
You also can't help but notice that there's a tremendous amount of controls on this preamp. It's sort of not just a simple gain box.
Right.
There's a lot going on here. Can you maybe tell us a little bit about the features and why you added them?
Sure. We wanted versatility in the unit. So for instance, we added a couple of different settings on we added some impedance settings, which would allow the engineer versatility in depending on the mic that is chosen and the artist, because some artists sound better depending on the impedance setting. So what happens is at one setting, it really adds character to that microphone. So it depends on what sort of character you're looking to pull out of the unit. At one setting, you might have what we consider a dark setting, and on the other end is a very open sounding. So it just depends on the microphone, and it depends on the artist. Now on the gain, what we decided was the most versatile was a stepped gain, which you'll see here. And what happens is you'll have this trim, which allows you the option of either the full amount of gain depending on each step. Here's the lowest, and here's the maximum of that particular setting. I wanted the engineer, the user, to be able to have versatility in the unit, and we knew that if we added that feature and allow the engineer to choose rather than us dictate, we knew that it would be a great sounding piece.
Andy, can you tell me a little bit more about what's in the signal path of the box?
Classic design calls for a transformer in and out. So we knew we wanted that. With the experience of running a lab for the past 25 years, we know that in order to be taken seriously, you really need to design, you know, have a design which calls for an audio transformer on the input as well as the output. And the three tubes really work in conjunction with the type of transformers that are there in order to give us the highest amount of gain. And because of the power supply, that gain is has a lot of clarity, and it once again adds a lot of versatility to the design.
The only other question I can think of off the top of my head that I'd like to ask is sort of, you know, how and why Presonus?
Yeah, we knew that building this was going to be an expensive situation, and we knew that in order to fulfill the type of design that we knew was going to be a hit, would have been really expensive. For instance, this box right here would have been at least double the price if it came out of our lab. But with Presonus in, you know, as a partner in this, they have the ability to manufacture very efficiently at the lowest cost possible without cutting corners. So the beauty is that they were able to take our design without changing a thing. And based on the ability of their ability to manufacture equipment, they were able to take our authentic design and carry it forward. And we knew that that would be the perfect situation for this particular unit.
Well, hats off. And thanks for coming out. We really appreciate it, Anthony.
Thanks for having me.